Alright guys, so I'm walking through Chinatown and I spotted this lobster place. They have fresh rainbow lobster. They have them on ice. You pick them up, they chop it up, they throw it on a grill for you, and they bring it out, and that's what we're doing today. So while we're waiting here for our food, the waiter came over when he took my order. They have a menu, full menu of seafood things at this little restaurant in Chinatown. They have scallops, they have shrimp, they have giant prawns, they have the jumbo lobster, which is what we're ordering today. And he tells you when he comes up, he goes, we have three different size lobster, which one you pick. They ranged in price from, I believe, 1,000 baht up to the one I got, which is 1,500 baht, which should be somewhere around $42-$43 in the US. It's pricey as far as meals go here in Thailand, considering that I can eat most days for, you know, $3 or $4 per meal. But I love lobster, so I'm in Thailand, it's fresh, and to me it's worth the money. So the jumbo lobster that they're using here today that I've got, I was told by the waiter, they ship this up from the south of Thailand. Because up here in Bangkok, at least as far as I know, there's no place for you to catch lobster. So they're trucked up daily fresh from the south. And then they come out to this food stall where you literally pick the one that you want, and based on size, you know, you pay for its size, its weight, and they will take it and cut it in half for you, steam it, and grill it right in front of you while you wait, and then they bring it to your table. So I've been patiently waiting about 20 minutes here. I'm getting real excited to have my lobster. It is still being broiled or grilling over on the other side of the restaurant. Can't wait at this point to give this a taste. One of the cool things about where I'm sitting right now is I actually get to watch one of the cooks as they prepare. Everyone else has come in, here's lobster. This place is very, very popular, it seems. It's right here in Chinatown. It's got tons of foot traffic. It seems like every other second or two, someone is coming into the restaurant ordering a lobster or one of the giant prawns or one of the other things on the menu. So it's definitely very, very busy here. Kind of chaotic and hectic while I sit here and look around. But that's one of the cool things about coming to Chinatown and eating here in Chinatown is nothing's really inside or air conditioned. You're out, you're in the middle of everything the entire time, and there's just tons of stuff going on. There's street hawkers everywhere. There's food stalls lined up right next to one another, and I'm about to enjoy a rather large lobster dinner right in the middle of all of this. So you have tons of entertainment, people watching while you're eating. This is a really cool place to come. It's a very interesting district here in Thailand. It's a lot different than downtown Bangkok where I've been staying. You can see the Chinese influence literally everywhere, from the Chinese script on the signs to the red Chinese balloons that are hanging everywhere, the Chinese food that is in for sale mixed with Thai food. This is a very unique place to come. And if you're gonna come to Thailand, this is definitely one of the places that you have to check out in the city. Muscly. It's got kind of a more delicate flavor to it than the tail meat does. A lot more sweetness as you get towards the head of the lobster. The tail meat is a heavy, obviously, because the animal uses that to swim, so it's more of a tougher muscle. As you get towards the tail, the meat is tougher, still has a rich texture, but much more of a bite to it.
You'll notice a little bit of this yellow up here. I believe they call this head butter or tamale. It's got a very rich flavor to it.
Yeah, that Thai seafood sauce just really sets us off. You get that good spice, a good burn. I actually happen to like spicy food here, and have yet to have any base too spicy for me in Thailand. So I really do enjoy the sweetness that you get from that burn in your mouth from the sauce when it's combined with the lobster. This is just one of the experiences that I highly, highly recommend here, culinary-wise. Bring yourself to Chinatown, get yourself one of these lobsters. I promise you're going to enjoy yourself. Thanks for watching, guys. Again, if you like this video, please like, comment, and subscribe on it. You can find us if you're watching on YouTube. You can also find us on Facebook at facebook.com/SaySarap. We're on Instagram at SaySarap. And if you're watching on Facebook, you can find us on YouTube at SaySarap. Again, guys, thanks for watching. Have a good one.